drift away.
Yo, what's good, everybody? Hope that y'all having a great day. And yes, the title does not lie. Today, I'm gonna be reacting to my old high school highlights. So for a while now, some of you guys have been asking me whether I had highlights of my own and you guys wanted to watch them. And I always said to them, I would always do it once I hit 10K. Well, we hit 10K, so I'm going to be reacting to my old high school highlights. And then afterwards, I'm gonna be doing the Q&A, so just stick to the end of the video, and that's when I'll do everyone's Q&A, because trust me, my highlights aren't that long. Now, I wasn't bad in high school by any means. I mean, I was second team all district, so I mean, that's cool, I guess. Should have been first, but hey, my teammate got first because he was scoring touchdowns like it was just too easy. That's an inside joke, but yeah. So, yeah, I was second team all district, made it to college to play football, so that's cool. But, I mean, I was an alright receiver, nothing special. But to stop with all the talking, today I'm gonna be reacting to Marcus Sharpe's highlight tape. In high school, I was a 6'2", 190-pound wide receiver. So just a quick preface to save some face. Basically, I was in a bad high school system, and they didn't really throw the ball that much, which was okay. I guess we had a really good running back and a really good quarterback who was also really good at running. So, hey, I mean, I can't really do anything about that. I could have done better to just be better overall at football, but we're not really passing the ball that much. It's whatever. But without making too many more excuses, let's just get right into this video. 3, 2, 1. Psh. All right, let's go back and just watch my high school highlights. So, yeah, let's just go back. All right, so let me just break down my stats here. So, second team all DVL, that's like the district that we were in. 20 receptions for 337 yards and 2 touchdowns. These are my senior year highlights, bro. Like, these seem trash, but when you realize how little that we passed the ball, like, I mean, I was the team's leading receiver with 337 yards. Like, that's how little we passed the ball. But 20 receptions, that's like 16.85, as I put there, yards average. So, I mean, I was getting first downs every single time I caught the ball. So, that's the most important. All right, so let's just get into this. Let's get into this. Oh my God, this is like going back in a time machine, yo. So this was, when was this? This was my first game in, no, this was the second game of my senior year. Yeah, and just, thank you, Garen, for that block. If you guys, I'm just gonna keep on going back because these are my highlights, so I know exactly what happened like during all this stuff. So, come across the field. So this is my homie, Garen, right here, as you guys can see by my mouse. Dude, absolutely, like, if he wasn't there for the block, I probably wouldn't score this. Look at this block. He takes out two of those guys clean out. And then you just see how slow I am, just barely making it. But your boy got into the end zone. This was our only, first and only playoff game that we had my senior year, going deep on the post, which we literally had this play the whole entire season, and we never threw it. And when we finally did, your boy caught it. So, I mean, that's what I was doing. Finding the openings, getting open. So, this play, come back, see my quarterback's in trouble. All you young receivers, always be looking out for your quarterback. If they're in trouble, come back to the ball, because they really appreciate that. I'd say about 80% of my catches were slants, and I love slants. Those are just the bomb. This was against our rivals, La Quinta. This was right after one of our players got like knocked out unconscious, and so I was like really fired up to like go out and do this. And after that play, I don't know if you guys can see it, I'll try and zoom in on the actual footage. So right here is where I'm getting pushed out, and I like run into a group of people. I hit our basketball coach and like sliced his arm open. Like, I don't know how, but like I felt so bad afterwards. Like, I didn't realize it then, but like afterwards, it was crazy. So you got your boy down there rocking the McDonald's, the McDonald's all American jerseys. God, I never understood why we didn't wear the white pants with the gold tops. I think those would look so much better, but we didn't. So, yeah, this is your boy out here in his prime. Actually, no, not my prime. I was way better in college. Like, I got so much better so fast in college. Yeah, basically these are just the little plays I run. Little jailbreak screen. This game, oh my God, was like the biggest lie ever. Our coach was like, yeah, if we play hard, we'll beat this team. This team was so good. We lost like 49-14. Okay, yo, check his play out, check his play out. This is a horrible cut, but I just put this dude on just a rail. I was like, oh, get your ankles taken, bruh. Get your ankles taken, bruh. and we're running some more slants, as you can tell, because of my horrible cuts. Like, honestly, if I just knew what I knew in that 1 year I played college ball, I would have been so much of a better wide receiver. The dude that tackled me is actually my former stepbrother. I don't know how you classify that, but he's going to San Diego State right now, so big ups to him. To play football. They didn't call this a touchdown, which was really dumb because I was very clearly in. But yeah, so that was kind of jank. Yeah, these are just all my catches because I had 20 of them, so I could afford to put them all in there. I probably was down. Like looking back at that, I was probably down with my knee there. But hey, I'll take the yards. Blocking. It wasn't the best. Okay, so now we got some just premium blocking highlights. So I actually didn't mean to even block that guy. I was just running my route and he just seemed to be in the way, and so I just kind of like just ran into him. This dude was so small, like it was just sad, like how small that quarter was. It was just bad. And I always preach don't give up on the play, and that's because your boy was giving up on the play too, and it didn't help. So everyone, when I say don't give up on the play, it's because, see, like, I wasn't giving up on the play on this, and this is what helped our running back score the touchdown. Like, that's good blocking. So when I say it, I mean it like out of a spot of, oh my god, I hated that dude so much. Oh my god, I hated that dude so much. He was so annoying. Oh my lord. Like, it wasn't that he was good. I mean, he was good. I think he's going to like Washington or something like that. But the dude was just annoying. Like, he would just like grab my face mask for no reason. Just like, and the ref would never call it because the ref was a Yeah, no, sorry. I'll bleep that out because I didn't really need to say that. But yeah, no, dude. Oh my god, I hated that kid so much. So we're going to just look at these prime blocking moves. I think that dude just slipped, but I still put it in there because, you know, you got to trick those college coaches into thinking that you're, you got to trick them into thinking that you're the stuff. This was our, like, this dude, Trey Reek, is a beast. Like, this dude is so, so good. So yeah, that was, those are my highlights. I'm expecting many comments of saying how trash I am because, to keep it 100, like I wasn't the best receiver, like by far. I mean, if we would have thrown the ball more, I was 6'2 in high school. Like, the corners I was going up against on average were 5'6 probably. But that post, that was the second play of my highlight, was the second or third time that we passed the ball deep to me. No hate on the quarterback, but it was like the first time it was like on target. So, cause our quarterback was good. It was just like the defense, like we played some pretty good defenses, but that was the first time it actually worked. And like, if we would have been doing that all year, things would have been going so much smoother. We would have went way deeper in the playoffs, but hindsight's 20/20, can't really change anything. I don't play football anymore. So yeah, I've come to live with my decisions in life though. Yeah. All right. So now we are going to be stepping into the Q&A part of this video because you guys actually kind of blew it up and you guys sent way more questions than I thought you would have. So we're just gonna get into a couple of them. I'm gonna start off on Instagram, then I'm gonna go to Twitter and answer a few, and then I'm gonna go onto my comment section and then answer those. So let's get right into it. So one of the more popular questions was, who is my favorite college and NFL team? So in college, even though I post a ton of Florida State videos, my favorite college team is USC. I am a diehard Trojans fan. There's the little Trojan icon like in the little corner. I mean, Snizzy Fizzy, that's the homie that hooked it up with the logo. So go look at his channel because that was tight. But yeah, so USC is my favorite team, and for the NFL, my favorite football team is the Broncos because, one, that was just a team that I liked watching, and little known fun fact, my second cousin, my dad's first cousin, is Shannon Sharpe, and that would also make Sterling Sharpe my second cousin as well. Little known fact. I mean, I realized after I got this little side part, I don't look just like him, but this is the exact haircut that he's rocking right now. So Shannon, hit me up if you want to like link up on some like sports talk stuff. I got you. And speaking of Snizzy Fizzy, he asked me on Instagram, why did I start YouTube? I basically started YouTube because, one, this was maybe like six to eight months after I finished football, like when I told myself I was done with football, and I didn't really have any other passions at the time. I didn't really know what I wanted to do or just what I wanted to do at all, like basically. And every single day, like I'm talking every single day for the past probably 5 years, I've watched a YouTube video, and I like always am on YouTube, always watching it. So I thought, well, why can't I make a YouTube video? And that's basically what happened. Now, I didn't have the immediate success that some of you guys might be thinking I have, just because I've been growing so fast. I mean, my first year on YouTube, I gained maybe 100 subscribers. I had no idea what I was doing. Please don't watch those old videos. They're so, so bad. There's no music on them. I have no life. They're just bad. But that's what needed to happen for me to get my personality, to find what I wanted to talk about. And now we're talking about football stuff, and it's lit. Naranjo9083 asks, do I have a girlfriend? No, I do not. My demographic says that like 95% of the people that watch my videos are guys. So if you guys got any hot sisters, yo, send them my way. You know what I'm saying? Your boy looking like Drake or Zeke. You know, I won't domestically abuse her though, because like, you know, I'm a good guy. So yeah, send them my way. Zachary Domenico asks, what do you think about DeAndre Francois' injury, and how do you think it's going to affect Florida State's chances this season? That is a massive injury. I'm just going to say it up front. I mean, I don't know much about their backup quarterback, and they still do have a really good team, but you need a solid quarterback at the helm of the offense. So I honestly don't know. I mean, at the beginning of the season, I had them as a surefire lock-in for the playoffs. Now they're going to have to prove some stuff to me. I mean, they lost their game to Alabama, so they're going to have to climb back into the top four. We'll see. I mean, the ACC is not the hardest division, but it's not the easiest either. So I mean, we'll see. I still have them top eight just because of how talented they are, but as far as getting back into the playoffs and that top four, it's going to be a challenge for them. Supreme for Life 11 asks, how fast is my 40 yard dash? At the fastest, I would say it wasn't official, but I'd say it was like 4.6 flat. Like right as I was like in the peak of my conditioning in college, like I got really, really fast. So I'd say I was like a 4.6 flat guy. Like I never had speed. I was always the size. Just throw me the ball and I'll just catch it. I was never a speedy guy. I was more of a possession red zone type wide receiver. So that was my 40. Ethan Snyder 24 asks, how many subs do you think I'll have in a year? Well, I always give myself really lofty goals. I feel like if you don't give yourself goals, it just kind of makes things hard to achieve. So my goal is to, by the Super Bowl, to have somewhere between 150,000 and 200,000 subscribers. So that's like roughly 4 to 6 months from now. So in a year from now, I'm hoping to have like 400,000 subscribers, because I think that's very possible. I think that with your guys' help, that you'll be able to make that a dream and a goal realized for me. So yeah, go tell all your friends about the channel, go have them hit the subscribe button, and watch all the videos. Stino Benny has a really good question. How do you want to make a positive impact in someone else's life? Basically, if there's one goal that I have that's not like just for myself or the channel, that like not a view goal or a subscriber goal, if there's just one goal that I want to have on this channel, is to genuinely, I want to react to someone, or I want to just watch someone's highlight tape, and for that tape to get a bunch of views and a college coach to watch that and offer that kid that they didn't even know. Like that would literally make my day if I was able to use my channel to put someone else on a platform where they were able to get noticed and get a scholarship. Like that would just make my whole year, like honestly. So Subscriber Sunday is all about you guys. Like that's literally, it's about you guys. I want to give you guys an opportunity to be on a bigger platform, because I was in a small high school, so I know how hard it is sometimes to get your name out there and to get plays to coaches. So that is the main reason why I do Subscriber Sunday, is to put you guys on a platform so hopefully a college coach will see you and give you an offer. So that's how I hope to make a positive impact on people's lives. All right, so now switching over to the Twitter questions. Chris Yarbo asks, what do you do in the average day? Make YouTube videos and sleep. That's about it. My life is pretty boring. I'm just trying to get content out to you guys. I'm trying to really grow this YouTube channel because I'm tired of having a normal job. I'm tired of not being able to have enough money living paycheck to paycheck. So I'm really trying to get this YouTube thing off the ground. So once I start working at the Boys and Girls Club, that's when I'll be going to work and doing that. And I'm probably gonna have to get a second job. So yeah, but that's basically my average day, is I just sleep and make YouTube videos. So Landon Tucker asks, what's my favorite player that I've reacted to? Definitely has to be a mix between Kalon Laybourne or Kalen. I like every single video that I post, someone says it's differently than how I say it. So it's either Kalen or Kalon. Zaquandre White, just because he had the first play of that video is ridiculous. Like I'm not even joking. If you haven't seen it yet, go watch it. I'll leave a link somewhere. The first play on his highlight tape is the craziest play I've ever seen, just hands down. It is the craziest play I've ever seen. And then Cam Akers was balling out. I think just those three running backs were like the three that really stood out, like, and Najee Harris. Like, okay, so those four players were just destroying everyone in high school. So now moving on to the YouTube questions. Sam Francis, who is an OG of the channel? I know who the OGs of the channel are, and Sam Francis has been here for a minute. He asked, how would you feel about Florida State versus USC in the postseason? Simple. I'd go with USC. like USC is my team. Like, Florida State has become my second favorite team, hands down. But I mean, you gotta go with like who you grew up rooting for, and so USC, like, that's just my team. Like, but I mean, if Sam Darnold keeps on playing the way he is, I don't see us in the playoffs. So hopefully that improves. Cameron Warner asks, which do I like better, college football or the NFL? I definitely like college football better, just because there's more teams, more variety, and I don't know, the NFL can seem kind of like mundane. Like, they just kind of, there's not a lot of excitement. Like, whereas in college, it's like you got the student section, they're just going crazy. You got all the players turning up. You got like these dudes who are like no-name players, then they'll like go for like 300 yards receiver or something crazy like that. So that I just love college football because like it's just so much energy going on. All right, and that is going to wrap up the Q&A. Thank you to everyone who sent questions in. If I didn't get to your question, I'm really sorry, but I don't want to make this video. I already know this video is gonna be crazy long, but I didn't want to make it like 20 minutes long. So thank you to everyone who sent your questions in. Just thank you to all the support that you guys have been giving the channel. Be fair for my highlights, because you know, your boy tried in high school. I mean, I really did try. All right, but if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to leave this video a like. Yo, can we get this video to 100 likes? That lets me know that you guys are enjoying these videos. Also, don't forget to comment down below of any other players that you guys want me to see, because that's how I know who you guys want me to watch so we can grow this channel. And also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you guys can stay on top of all the videos that, hey, I'm coming out with. Yeah, hey, hey, yeah, hey, one, two, yeah. All right, but with that all being said, hope y'all have a great day, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Ciao.